All right, Brock. I didn't get to talk to you after EWL's tough match in the finals, right? But it looks like you bounced back pretty good. Chad Red has you in a really bad spot in the third period. Double underhooks. He's walking you around the mat. It almost goes body lock. He almost puts you on your back. You get a stall call. How do you survive that situation, win that match?
Just staying tough. I know after EWL's, I got pinned. And it was just it's a not-so-friendly reminder that I'm not invincible. So when I get in these tough situations, I don't panic anymore, which is like kind of how that match ended up being able to get back to my offense and staying tough again when he got me in danger on that single. So just being comfortable in all the positions and training hard after that EWL's loss just kind of put everything back in focus for me.
You know, you look at Chad Red. The guy's legit. He's a blue chip. He's a stud. That's not a great first-round matchup for you. I didn't like that when I saw it. You know, me being an EWL guy, I'm just like, I don't like that matchup.
Right.
Getting out of that one with the win, you know, what did it take, and where was your mind at? What was Coach Ferraro telling you?
For me, after that EWL performance, I just didn't overcomplicate anything. Went back to the drawing board and said, how do I win? That's being offensive, attacking legs for 7 minutes. And I knew Chad Red was a good first draw. Not in a sense that I wanted it, but in a sense, if I can do it on him, then I can do it on anybody. So it set the tone for the rest of the match. I'm confident. You know, 5 matches in a row, I want to wrestle 7 minutes of attacking. I didn't quite do it that match, but that's the game plan moving forward, and I can fix it now. So just positive.
Clarion, you know what I mean? What a tradition, right? You know, and you guys from 2 years ago are not even the same team.
Right.
It's incredible, the improvement. The dual meet wins. How you guys performed at EWLs. Guys punching tickets who probably weren't supposed to be here. What's it say about the program and the come up and you know, from when you started to now?
Yeah, we're going forward. You know, I came in, and it's not that I always knew and I always believed in Coach Ferraro and his vision. When I came in, I thought, boy, we have our hands full. But, you know, guys graduated, things changed, and people were buying in. These young kids, they're gritty, they're tough. They're not okay with losing because they're young. And that's kind of what's kept us going forward. That, good grades, good kids, it's made a huge difference.
Having Levon, him coming in, what's it been like working with him?
It's huge. You know, those situations where I said, where I got it, everything's easy to see when everything's good. You know, when you're taking a guy down 100 times, it's easy to say, okay, cut him, get up again. But when I get taken down or I get put in a position where I'm about to get thrown, that's where it's hard to stay positive. And having Levon, going with him where I get in those situations, you know, every time we wrestle, it's totally changed my ability and what I can do. I can just shut up and keep grabbing legs. Never could before.
All right, man. Who you got next?
Thorn or Mason Smith?
You ready to go?
I'm so ready.
All right, man. Good luck. Thanks for the time.
Thank you.